Hi everyone, it's Lisa Mears and I'm here for a pretty pink posh today. Today I'm going to be making a card using the brand new Build a Gift die set. This die set is so versatile. You can use it for birthday cards, you can use it for Christmas cards, you can use it for basically any occasion where you need to give a gift. So this is a die set which you would use for paper piecing. So it's so versatile because you can die cut these pieces out in any color cardstock that you want and then just piece them together to build your gifts. So I've already done some die cutting with various shades of cardstock. So my color scheme is the teal, I have some hot pink, and I have some orange, and I'm just going to build these gifts. So before I start gluing these pieces together, I always like to add ink to the edges of the cardstock because I feel that it just adds some extra definition. So I'm taking a color ink that matches the color cardstock and I'm just adding some ink to the edges. And you can already see that little bit of definition that appears on the edges of that rectangle. And notice that that rectangle that I die cut, it also has some stitching lines. So this die does put those stitching lines in that rectangle, which just adds for some further definition of that gift. So I die cut the solid piece that this stitched piece is going to go on. So the solid piece is I die cut out of the teal. I'm just going to add this orange piece right to the top. You might wonder, why am I just adding this stitched piece to a top of a piece of cardstock? And that's because I just wanted to have a slight color display through those stitched lines. So next I'm taking this pink piece. I die cut this out of the present with the holes. I'm just poking those holes out and I'm taking a pink ink and just adding some definition to the edges of that present. I die cut the solid square out of teal cardstock. So I'm going to put glue on the back of this pink piece and then I will add it to the solid piece. And you can see those fun polka dots showing through the present. You can see that when I move this to the side that it's not completely flat because of those holes that are in that present. You can choose to leave it that way if you like that dimension, or you can fill in the holes. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to take that die again. I have double-sided adhesive tape on the back of this teal cardstock and I'm going to run this through the die cutting machine. And what that does is it gives me a piece that's a complete sticker, and now I can just take those holes and I can just pop them right in to the holes on the actual present that I'm using with the pink cardstock. So I'm just taking the adhesive backing off and popping all of those holes that are the stickers into the places on the pink gift. And what's neat about this is if you wanted to have your polka dots in various colors, just take that die and die cut it in different shades of cardstock and you can have a different look. So next I'm going to add the ribbon around the presents. So I have this die I die cut out of some teal cardstock. You can see how that fits perfectly on that large present. You can also use the style ribbon for the smaller present. You'll just have to trim off the ends of the cardstock that extend beyond the present. So I'm going to go ahead and add some teal ink to the ends of that ribbon and then I will add glue and add that to my orange present. Next, I'm going to take the smaller die and I'm going to use this ribbon for the smaller present. This particular ribbon has stitching line down the middle, so I love the detail in these dies. I added ink to the edges and then I'm just going to add the glue and add this ribbon down the center of this present. Next, I'm going to die cut some bows. For the small bow, there are two dies. The bottom die gives you just a solid piece. And then the top die, it will actually cut out all the different parts of the bow. And you can see all of those die cut pieces there on my table. So I'm going to go ahead and add glue to the back of all of these pieces and then just add them to the solid bow that I die cut out. You can see I have two different color cardstock pieces here. I have a darker piece on the bottom and then the lighter yellow on the top. So I'm just filling this in, adding glue, and just kind of like putting these pieces together to create this bow. So once I finish gluing all of those pieces down, I just take some yellow ink and just add some ink to the edges just to add some more definition. And then I'm going to add that bow to the top of this smaller present. So now my first present is completely put together. So moving on, I'm going to do the larger bow. I die cut out of solid pink. And then there's also the layering bow that I die cut out of a lighter pink. So I'm going to go ahead and do the same thing I did previously and just glue these smaller pieces onto the darker solid bow. This time I'm going to leave the top part of the bow with the darker pink showing in the background, just so that it looks like it has more definition. So you can see that darker pink there on the top. I'm going to leave those two pieces off. If you wanted to fill those in, you could, but I'm going to leave those off for now. And once my bow is put together, I will add some pink ink to the edges just for some more definition. And then I will add that bow to the larger present. So I'm just going to stick it there on the middle where the ribbon connect, and there is my present. I did create one more present. This time it's just going to be teal. It is a larger present in teal. I'm going to add ink to the edges. And with this present, I wanted to create a third present, but I didn't want it to be the same size as the others. So I'm going to take it and I'm going to cut it in half. And this will give me two presents, but I'm only going to use one. So after I cut it in half, I need to finish this up by adding more ink to the edge that I cut. I die cut a pink ribbon. This is a lighter pink cardstock, and I'm adding ink to the edges of that. And then I'm going to add that ribbon to my smaller present. And because that ribbon is larger than the gift, I'll just snip off the extra cardstock that extends beyond the edges, and then I will add a bow to the top. And there is my third present. For the sentiment of my card, I'm using the Birthday Scripts stamp set. I love this stamp set because there are so many different ways to put together a sentiment for a birthday card. So you have some larger words like celebrate, party, wishes, birthday, for you, and then you have some smaller words there on the right. And you can combine those sentiments to form different sentiments. So you can say happy birthday, birthday wishes, make a wish, it's a party, a gift for you. So there's so many different ways you can put those together, and then they also have the matching dies that will die cut the sentiment out as well. So I'm going to go ahead and start putting this card together. I die cut a frame out of the scallop frame dies, and I'm just resting that frame on top of a piece of white cardstock that measures 4 1/4 by 5 1/2. And that's gonna kinda give me a guide to see where I wanna stamp my sentiment. And my sentiment is going to say birthday blessings. So I was trying to see where I wanted to put the word blessings, whether I wanted it underneath the word birthday. I ultimately decided to move the word birthday over to the left and then have the word blessings off to the right. So it's important that I had that scallop frame on top of that cardstock piece so that I knew where exactly I needed to stamp that sentiment. I didn't want that sentiment to be too far down on that white cardstock, otherwise that scallop frame would eventually cover it up. So I already positioned my presents how I want them to appear on my card. So I'm going to go ahead and add the scallop frame first so that it is glued down to this white cardstock. And then I will go ahead and take these presents and I will glue them down, starting with the teal present because it is the one that is in the back of all of the presents. Then I will glue down the pink present, and then I will add the larger present right on top. Next, I added some of the flamingo pearls and the sunshine pearls. So the flamingo pearls are the pink ones, the sunshine pearls are the yellow ones, and these are also new to Pretty Pink Posh. So I added them around my card, and then I added this card layer to an A2 size white card base. And that completes my card. So if you liked this video, please give it a thumbs up and be sure to subscribe for more card making tutorials. Thank you for watching and have a great day, everyone. Bye-bye.